Sydney is staring down the barrel of a waste crisis with warnings red bins may no longer be collected within a matter of years, all because the landfills in one of our biggest cities are dangerously full, now prompting a rubbish reckoning.
Sydney, you have a major junk problem.
We are not kicking this down the road any longer. This is an urgent issue. There's no time to waste.
Our most densely populated city on track to run out of landfill space in less than 6 years.
Issues that we're going to have to confront. Otherwise, people are not going to be able to have their red bins picked up.
It's a fate that could see Sydney's trash sent regional or even interstate for disposal.
It absolutely is just putting a band-aid on. What we need to be doing is sending far less to landfill, because 70% of what ends up in landfill could have been recycled.
Today, the New South Wales government taking action with a comprehensive new waste plan that includes incentivising landfill operators to recycle more and forcing households to compost.
40% of your red bin actually has food waste in it and other organics. If we can get that out of landfill, good for the environment, but also good for waste disposal.
And the issue isn't Sydney's alone. Last year, the nation produced almost 76 million tonnes of waste, an average of 540 kilograms of household waste per person. We send about 20 million tonnes of that to landfill annually, while our recycling rates have stagnated over the last decade.
The waste crisis in Australia has become dire. The reason it's spiralling out of control, it's quite simple. We consume far too much. We buy too much.
In fact, we could all be on the brink of saying goodbye to our red household rubbish bins, because there simply won't be anywhere for that trash to go.
If we were to get rid of our red bin, then the waste becomes the responsibility of the individual. The average consumer would need to consume either less, or the products that they do purchase, they're able to then recycle.
So how can we save our country from this burgeoning waste crisis? Or is it already too late?
Scary question. Here to tell us is waste management expert and Australia's first garbologist, Belinda Chellingworth. Belinda, thanks so much for joining us. How have you personally been able to cut down on your waste?
Well, I've been helping business and community reduce their waste for over 20 years, and I figured I needed to be doing it too. So many years ago in the early 2000s, I started just concentrating on one little thing that was in my landfill bin, like single-use plastic bags, and I would find a way to reduce or eliminate that, swap it with a reusable, and I would just pick one thing at a time as I went, until eventually I didn't need my red landfill bin anymore, and now I just use a little Tupperware container for my waste.
And how often would you fill that little Tupperware container?
Every 2 weeks.
Oh, okay. So that to me sounds incredible. And it also sounds like something that isn't that achievable in my life, but something I would love to aspire to. What do you think the biggest barrier is for all of us doing the same and having our own little Tupperware containers?
I think it can feel very overwhelming. Like when you first look at your bin, there's so much waste in there and you just think, oh, where do I start? And we get a bit disillusioned and we don't do anything. So it's really just about picking one thing. It might be cling wrap and using a reusable container. It might be your food waste. You might notice some tomatoes in your fridge tonight that are, you know, on the blink, and you can put them in bolognese sauce tomorrow. So it's just picking one little thing at a time and not putting lots of pressure on yourself to try and get rid of your bin overnight, because that's probably not very achievable.
So just to remind us, what's the size of that little Tupperware again, everybody?
This big, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just checking.
Could probably fit about 2 sandwiches in it, to give you a sense.
Delicious. Wow. So how much of this then should be on the consumer, as you say, but then how much of this should be on governing bodies who are making sure that it's all going to the right places, like this landfill that's just been being sent out to other places to be buried?
So it's absolutely a shared responsibility between government, business and all of us at home. So government could implement better policy, which helps us reuse and repair things as well, so we don't have to throw out our stick vacuum or our TV when it breaks. But for us at home, it often surprises people to learn that of all the food waste we generate in this country, the majority is in our kitchens and in our households.
Belinda, would you recommend, like, going to the supermarket and just eating the food in the supermarket, so you're not taking any waste with you back home and not taking any leaving any mess behind.
A loophole.
Oh, goodness. Well, there are supermarkets overseas where you can take the packaging and the recycling back if you want to. So that idea's...
What overseas are we talking about?
So, you know, that idea's not too far-fetched.
Great. That's where we should send our rubbish. Mm.
Belinda, are there countries who are doing it better than us and can we borrow some ideas from them?
So we often look to the Netherlands and France as being our waste reduction heroes. Like in France at the moment, you can go to and buy products like laptops or even your lawnmower, and there's a little star rating on it there and it will tell you how repairable it will be, so you can make a choice about how long that product might last. In the Netherlands, they've had a huge campaign, and we've actually just launched one in Australia to help people at home reduce their food waste as well. So those are two of our hero countries.
Belinda, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
I mean, really sobering stuff, but at the same time, I couldn't help but think that we really could have introduced her as Herlinda Chillingcurse. But anyway.
I see.
I worry about this. It's one of those things that I think for many people, it's been in the back of my mind of...
It's been in the back of your mind.
It has.
The red one. Pun.
Why am I doing the voice? but the reality of it now hitting is quite confronting.
Mm. Well, I think it's something that I've always been like, well, surely that's in the to-do later pile, right? Like, that's for the to-do later. But it really is.
Because the bigger out later is it always comes around.
I know.
Yeah. It does happen eventually.
I know.
And 6 years is a very short period of time for later to come.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Yeah. So hopefully we can implement some of these changes and, I don't know, somehow make a difference.
Do you think you could actually, let's all be real here, this is your waste. This is the amount of waste that you can have in 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
No, that's I would find that really hard. But I aspire to it. But yes. I think that would be really hard.
I think the danger with whenever we talk about things like this is that it seems like such an overwhelming problem.
Yeah.
That everyone's like, oh well, what can I do to change that? Mm. You know. But then Belinda's just shown us like if we can at least think about it.
And also small changes over time, which is what she was saying. Small changes over time. You don't have to change everything right now. Small changes over time.
But also that little thought that we were having today, that idea. Well, if I put something in, like say, the recycling bin. Mm. I feel like I've done my bit, but it would be nice to know that then the next steps are being done to dispose of it the right way.
Absolutely. Yes.